ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ. ವಿ ಸೀಕ್ ದ ಬ್ಲೆಸ್ಸಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಲ್ ಮೈಟಿ ನಟರಾಜ, ಶ್ರೀ ಗಣೇಶ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ ಅವರ್ ಗುರುಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಬ್ಲೆಸ್ಸಿಂಗ್ ಅಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಅಸ್ ಸಚ್ ವಂಡರ್ಫುಲ್ ಆರ್ಟಿಸ್ಟ್ ಸೋ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಫೋರಮ್ ಇಂಟರ್ವ್ಯೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ಆರ್ಟಿಸ್ಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ದೆಮ್ ಟು ದಿಸ್ ಹೋಲ್ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್. ಆನ್ ಬಿಹಾಫ್ ಆಫ್ ಫೆಡರೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಕಲ್ ಡಾನ್ಸರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ, we welcome you all to the show, a unique journey of celebrated dancers of our own Karunadu, Karnataka. Today we have a great personality who has learned Mohiniyattam, personified Mohiniyattam and propagated Mohiniyattam across the world, and we are very proud of introducing Guru Srimati Sridevi Unni to you all. I take this honor and pleasure to read out her wonderful sadhana to you all. The name Sridevi Unni is like the melody of a wind chime in the most gentle breeze that brings in the mind of one of the visual of a dancer, an actor with 41 films to her credit, an entrepreneur, the one with the most gracious smile, and a director too, a woman with substance who has inspired many, being a role model, and one whose words and voices always motivate each one irrespective of gender, age and backgrounds with one message: you can, you can. A renowned dance exponent in Mohiniyattam with several choreographies and dance ballads, both with mythological and social relevance, each which leaves an impact on the audience. In the years 2020 and 2021 is where Guru Srimati Sridevi Unni reached out to a wider audience through her Bhavanritta online series with unique choreographies and leaving one mesmerized with the same, and also pondering about one can make use of time, space and ideate with limited resources we had. Her venture into the world of direction was one where she proved her mettle and talent in bringing alive characters portraying a simple day-to-day incident many live but fail to recognize. The short film Resonance. The Resonance won several awards, including the Best Drama Film, the Best Film, the Best Director, Special Jury Mention, and an honorable mention by short film festivals like Bangalore Short Film Festival, the KIFF, the IFFC, and so on. Sridevi Unni, the director of Performing Arts School, Monisha Arts, has nurtured and trained more than 600 students till date who are today pursuing dance through teaching or as performing artists in India and abroad. Her choreographies broke the barriers of Mohiniyattam, being a dance form from Kerala but familiar to the audience of Karnataka, as she used lyrics in Kannada. Her work speaks volumes, and she earned her recognition through each piece of her work she knitted, keeping the traditional framework intact yet reaching it to vast and wide audience of the world. She has won the coveted Karnataka State Chandana Award by Doordarshana in 2019, presented by Governor of Karnataka. The Karnataka Kalashri Award in 2002, the Pravasi Kalashri Award in 2013, and many more accolades till date. She continues her work with the same zest and guides, mentors, and ensures youngsters pursue their dreams too by the walking, talk sessions and things like that. Such a unique personality we have amongst us today. Welcome Guru Srimati Sridevi Unni ma'am for this unique talk show led by Federation of Karnataka Classical Dancers and ably programmed by Shri Sai Venkatesh sir. Sai Venkatesh sir, welcome to the show. Without no delay, the floor is open to you both for a great exploration today. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Sagar. Wonderful. Namaskaram, madam.
Namaskaram. Namaskara, Sai.
Namaskara. How are you?
I'm good. I'm so
yeah,
happy.
You look...
Yeah.
You look very good. You look very good.
So thank you so much for the compliment.
Our Federation of Karnataka Classical Dancers, so we are trying to discuss, talk, and know more about the journey of wonderful dancers, dance gurus who have taken this as their profession. It's very nice we have you today. It's a great honor for us. And to all the dancers of our world, and also the Mohiniyattam, complete team of Mohiniyattam in our country. We just wanted to know something about how you went into Mohiniyattam. Did Mohiniyattam call you, or you went to Mohiniyattam, or in the school days it was just a jolly to go and dance? And how was it when you started? I think decades back.
Yes, that's a lovely question. Because now I chose the Mohiniyattam, or the Mohiniyattam chose me. It is just accidental. See, when I start my journey from much, I think I have to say a little pre-independence of India. That is my seniority. So when in Kerala, I was born and brought up in Kerala in Calicut. I had a fantastic, very beautiful, cultural, rich atmosphere. So my mother was a real key point of the whole thing. And we were being trained, all the girls in the family were being trained to do the Kaikottikali and the Kummi. That was the original dance form, the folk dance form, especially in group. Because we always believe the group will have more energy in the very... It is educative, it is by physical exercise or knowledge-wise, the singing and the dancing, everything in the group. That was the origin of my dance. From the Kaikottikali Kum, that is the, then later on, when I was 14 only, I started learning Mohiniyattam. Till that, my gurus were one Sri Kelappan sir, and no more, they are no more. And then Kathakali, I learned from Balakrishnan Nair. So these two were my gurus when I was very small. And I have two sisters. We always do the dance together. The studies are together, practice. And my mom was a Nimishakavi, you know, the poet. She writes all the lyrics for the dance dramas. They're like Shiva Parvati or Radha Krishna, Ras Leela. And Menaka, Vishwamitra Menaka, etc. Because I also like to be the female character, and I wanted to attract the audience. I think I am very confident. I was very confident in the childhood itself. I always wanted to be on the limelight. It's my psychology.
You didn't have any fear when you're put on the stage. When you went to perform.
I think it is just that we call it the genes, no, or from the genes. So inborn. This is my inborn feeling, the sai bhava was that. And later on, and it was going on, that was the sir was teaching us the form like oriental dance, which is from Guru Gopinath. Oriental dance, because no Bharatanatyam were available those days in Kerala. No dance teachers were there. Only one teacher from Madras, I think his name was Ms. Achyutan Nair. He comes to Calicut just to teach few families. He go to the house, then teach. And we didn't have that chance to learn Bharatanatyam because my family was more into this traditional dance forms and Kathakali and like that, for dance-wise. But it's a contrast. My mother was not a dancer. She was a connoisseur. She was a promoter. And she knows all the, she has taught me all the bhavas, the shringara. When I was 6 years, 7 years, I was doing the Menaka role, and my sister Sri Kumari, elder to me, 1 year, she was a Vishwamitra. So how do a small girl, 6-year-old girl, will show the shringara? Without Shringara, Menaka won't be successful, right? So yeah. I was dressed up like me. I had a lot of confidence, and she told me, how do you show the Shringara? My first lesson from my mother for the Bhava. said, you should have the proper bhava, Shringara. She's just such a small girl. How to teach her? He said, you look down. Say, I look. My sister was right side to me. She was like dressed up like Vishwamitra. I was the Manika with all nice veil and all. She told me, you look there. Just look at her first. Keep your this down, face down. Look at her slowly. Then smile at her and do something like this. And come back and look down. Again look. Then smile. This is a singer I was. I learned from her. I did exactly and got a best huge silver cup for my Abhinaya on the stage when I was only just 6 or 7. That was
great,
my first
wonderful
award, and that
great,
was
wonderful.
My first I got.
Wonderful.
I thought, okay, let me try.
So that was a sort of boost in your life to take it up seriously into Mohiniyattam.
I have to tell everywhere. This was in me. It's like it's a default. In me, the dance, the music, the imagination is always in me till today. Then,
so we can call you a born dancer.
Yeah. My 14th year, when I was 14, we found a very good guru in Mohiniyattam, Kalamandalam, Calicut Chandrika. She was a very young girl, almost my age, because when she was coming from Kalamandalam after the graduation, and very young, maybe 17 or 18. I was also maybe 14 I am. She must be 17. And my mother introduced her to the Calicut crowd, holding a very beautiful meeting and introduced her to the Calicut crowd. She is from Kalamandalam. She's a beautiful girl. And she started teaching. And so my mom sent her own girls also along with the other students. So then I started all my Mohiniyattam, the beginning of Mohiniyattam from Kalamandalam Chandrika. She's no more. So simple, humble people. And those days, what do you call? It is not a Gurukula. They cannot explain so much about the social thing and many things. They are not like that. They can really explain to you what is how to do the dance and what is the bhava, what is the story, like very simple method of teaching. But I discover now, those generation, my generation, when I was small, I told you, maybe some 50, 60 years back, I'm talking about that age. So 60 or 70 years back. And we had I don't know how. I think because of the cultural background of listening to Ramayana, listening to Mahabharata, all the mythological, and all the other, whatever the other religion also, their stories, what was a Nabi and who was a Nabi, and like that many things, and the history of Tipu Sultan, all this, all sort of history we learn, All those things always gives us some impression in the mind. So with the creativity, I think when the master, I used to grasp very fast. When she says, this is the Rama Saptam, this is the way Jagam Dagirisham Adisha, who is the Rama? Like that they say. The Dasharatha Rajkumara. Namari Chaspahu Vidara. This also she will say. But my imagination goes, Dasharatha. Dasharatha Rajkumara is Rama. Oh, then I love Rama. I am a devotee of Rama. Oh, I have the bhakti. Oh, Krishna. I have the Krishna. I have the bhakti.
Okay.
So this is the I used to grasp. So and then
wonderful.
My journey started when I was 14 in Mohiniyattam.
So your journey started with the so intimate blessings and one-to-one teaching from the Guruji. But did you later on try to specialize something about it, and did you go to any institutions like Kalamandalam or any college or something to advance yourself?
I tell you how it is. See, dance was not the career, was not a profession for us on those days. We never have given that, the professionalism in dance. That was for enjoyment. And you enjoy yourself. That was the policy that I had gone through. That was the thing I could understand. You are dancing for divine. You are dancing for yourself. And that is, was the thing. So we never knew the academic thing. I never knew. And later, later on, I started working myself also. And it's a long story. And my mother had told me to do the choreography of dance dramas. So I was a director in dance drama when I was only 16, I'm 17. And she will watch, and there'll be good audience. Lalita Kala Academy, she was there, or their group was running a very, very beautiful sabha. And I used to, I have to dance, and I have to direct. I have to do only the Bhagavad Gita. They will be singing and doing the, playing the mridangam and tabla and things like that. It was like that. After that, I had a passion for Mohiniyattam. And all the while, I was missing Bharatanatyam. That was my secret. Oh. I really wanted to become a Bharatanatyam dancer. But told you, I didn't get that kind of chance to learn Bharatanatyam. But, and I wanted, what I wanted to learn in Bharatanatyam, you know, all the old items like Kalaituki in the Adum Devame. Then the other one is the Thaye Yashoda. I told my mom, Amma knew what is what I really want. I said, you got a very beautiful dancer. She was an officer's wife for the State Bank of India, the top guy's wife from Tamil Nadu. And very beautiful, stunning lady. And I always, you know, go after this beauty. Because a dancer, no? She's a dancer, tall and beautiful. Then I said, okay, Shandamma will teach you Bharatanatyam. And from the school, their building was right in front of my school. So in the afternoon, after lunch, the Amma will send somebody to take me to the cross the road and go to that house. From there, and she taught me the basic of some Bharatanatyam. It's not complete ados and all. They were not bothered those days. Because then from there, Taye Yashode, she taught me. So that was my favorite thing I was doing. And later on, I was thinking others are doing some Palachi Varnam and all that. All this Varnam I wanted to learn. And somehow the years passed by. But I was always singing and dancing through and through in my life. So then after then I started working on myself and I was interacting with big gurus. And much later, when I did that Gandhari Vilapa, I got a very big guru for all my corrections and advice from late Shivaraman Ashan from Kathakali. Kathakali Ashan Shivaraman and Sri Pisharadi. Kalamandalam, this thing, head he was those days.
Yes.
That was a very big teaching I got. Then I was going on and on working, Sasai. I was, even today, I do the research work on myself. It's not in black and white, but my mind is just want to acquire knowledge. So I keep watching everyone, every form of dance.
Do you feel it is better to be to work as a solo dancer, or do you think it is good to work with a group, or do you think you feel like doing more of choreographic presentations? What is your passion?
I know solo dance. For solo dance, you need solo dance. But I always wanted to be in the group presentation because storytelling. Yeah. That is the way I can reach to people. That lesson I learned only after coming to Bangalore. That trick I understood. I had to do the group and to adapt the language. And I had a very good mentor in Karnataka. That was much later. But before that, I have to mention few very beautiful dance fraternity when I came to Bangalore in 1975. When I came, I was in my just 30. And I don't know how I was introduced to the Karnataka crowd, like Srimati Leela Ramnathan. And they all came to know there is a dancer coming from Kerala for Mohiniyattam. By the time I had already started performing in Malayali club here and there, and always I was teaching. I love to teach. I had students at home. No, I at home was my my husband used to encourage me in teaching. When you teach, okay, you will learn more. Teach and learn, like that. Huh? So that was going on. Then Leela Ramnathan, madam, and Lalita Srinivasan, and Narmada, they were all my friends. And they were all, we used to conduct the workshop, I mean, the demonstration in different places, like, I don't remember, some big hotels also, we used to have some gathering. No, there, okay, very seriously, with all the podium and all, we used to demonstrate. I used to do the Mohiniyattam, the Bharatanatyam, all the old generation. Okay. So they were really so close to my heart. I know that I can never forget that. That was the welcome I got, encouragement.
So after you came to Karnataka, you established your institution and you trained the innumerous artists and innumerous dancers. Today we have one more artist with us. You are one of your seniors today, Anita Ji, Anita Peter. Okay. We would like to have Anita Peter with us. And she's been dancing for a long time and I've seen a lot of her performances. And she's a wonderful dancer.
Hello,
Anita Ji.
Namaste, Sai.
I also seen Anita Peter going on a motorbike, bullet bike, roundabout, climbing the Himalaya mountains. She's not just a wonderful student of yours. Yeah.
Yes.
Anita Ji, how do you relate yourself to your guru and what sort of relations and how you feel associated with your madam?
My relationship with Sridevi auntie, as I call her, started now. It is going to be 20 years very soon in November. So, so it is a very special journey altogether. So from I think from confidence building, that's where it started. To let me believe that being a mother of a child, I can start learning. So I would say from confidence building to grooming my body language to for Mohiniyattam, and then to train in her, like, you know, me in dance. And also she taught me work-life balance. And that is the way I was able to manage both my family as well as dance. And above all, when I had to move from Bangalore to Hyderabad, it was very heartbreaking for me to leave so much behind. And she made me believe that every beginning has something to look forward to. And that is how, with her blessing, I was able to start an institute myself. And she helped me nurturing my students, and I would call her the grand guru of my students. So it's been a beautiful journey, an impactful journey.
Lovely. Okay. Lovely. Thank you, Anita Ji, for being with us.
Thank you.
Wonderful. That's a great relationship with your Guruji. Guruji, we have one more artist with us, one more person with us. His name is Vikram Suri. Your journey with film world, you have been so much connected with the film world. And so many things are happening. You have been directing, acting, and doing so many things with the film. Vikram Suri is one of a wonderful young Bharatanatyam dancer, trained from wonderful gurus. And he is into the celluloid and the multimedia thing and serials. He's a very famous artist of our Karnataka. He's been traveled around the world and given a lot of programs. And he is also a director in serials and films. He's one more film, he has just feature film, he has just done it and it's ready for release. Vikramji, Guruji is here.
Sridevi.
Namaste, madam.
Would you like to do something with the, can you discuss something about the film and dance choreography, Vikramji?
Sure, definitely, Sai sir. I think today I'm very blessed and honored to share some precious time with madam.
Thank you. Yes. Nice to see you. The young people of who are, I'm really happy to see the young generation.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. I have some two, three not questions, to just share some things with you, with our media, film media. How do you like connect the classical dance forms in movies? Apart from the olden days, we had many choreographies, very good dance gurus who used to do very previously. After some time, it was discontinued. And again, in recent movies like Devdas, all these kinds of movies, again, we are seeing some classical based dances. What do you say about this?
This is mainly from the film, from the completely our traditional art level. It has been taken to the commercial part of it also. Because a person, a producer who is investing the money, they want the return.
Yes.
So how many people will go and see a film with the pure classical dance? And even they can't take, that was one, I'm very clear, there was a period of time after Shankarabharanam and all, after what is Telangai Oli, all those things, there was a radical change in that. So many social films have started coming because the society has changed. Because they wanted more realistic. I remember my inspiration was Vaijayanti Mala, dancer, actor, and all. Vaijayanti Mala, Padmini, Ragini. These three were my, I was worshipping them when I was small. So because I see them through the dance, through the film. I see their dance through the film. That time, everybody liked to see that. All mythological stories. Now we became social. The social stories. So how can you, can have one dance, maybe one college day, one girl is dancing Bharatanatyam, and you are, what is the thing you are showing from the audience side? Ooh, like that. Ooh. So this is the kind of things happening. So that is it. Actually, it is, it has to happen. It is a change. Again, this will come back. It's a cycle. No, now what happened because of the pandemic? A lot of people are coming together in classical. Now many people know what is a classical dance now. Anybody will know through the internet. No, through the media. That is, I think that is the change happened in the social environment and the society. But we need the change also. But in between, if we have Shankarabharanam and Asa, that kind of one serious thing, if you can produce, if they can present it, we'll have to yet to see whether how many people will be there to see. Now it's a bad scene because no theater for another 1 year. I don't think we can go to the theater and watch the real, the typical film, no?
Yes.
That is
Vikram,
that's what
Swari,
I have
Vikram Swari ji,
yes.
Why don't you plan something? You're doing so much of serial works and short films and things like that. And Madam has also done some short film. Why don't you both plan something for our society to encourage the youngsters to go work in a deep classical form? Would you have any plans to work with Madam and do some sort of serial or a small episodes or one short films or something like that, Suriji?
Of course,
definitely, Sai sir. See, what Madam said, there are two things. One is like commercial movies and another is like art movies. See, once we go with commercial movies, definitely producer will be willing to have money return.
Yes.
Art movies, when we plan, we do with our passion. We won't go for money.
Yes.
So in such kind of works, definitely we will plan. See, yeah, every artist, we need money also. At the same time, for our relaxation and all, for all those things, we need artwork. That,
so
is,
that,
for
is,
our, yes. That is for our heart.
Our heart, correct.
Yeah.
But we need that kind of producers also who has got the art in heart.
Yes.
That if they are ready to.
Yes.
It's a, you know, I tell you, the financial background is something, it is, that is the main thing in life. We have to have, because without promoters, you cannot. Even
yes.
if the If you have the festival, it's all with the sponsor. So you know that in Natya Shastra itself, we want three things for the dance. We want a good stage, the sponsor, and the audience. Without these three things, a dancer cannot come on the stage. Same way, there are facts, no? You require. Yeah. How can you motivate the people? And there, I suggest there should be a public funding.
Definitely. Good. Yeah.
Little money from everybody. It'll know.
Yeah, wonderful.
It's just like that, no?
Yes.
All the drops will make an ocean. That is the way we can work.
Yes. And little this film media inspires everyone. So in that connection, I would like to ask you a question, madam. In olden days, like we used to go and just, we were telling our dance gurus only like, we need to learn dance. That's it. Nowadays, the parents come with their kids and they will say, my daughter is inspired with this kind of movie. She dances and she wants to learn the dance. So what do you say about this kind of situation, ma'am?
That is a very funny situation because they said, is there any competition? They used to come, ma'am, are you conducting any competition, dance competition? I said, of course. We'll have all the five main dances of India in the classic we can have. Bharatanatyam, Kuchipudi, Mohiniyattam, Kathak, all those things. Odissi. No, ma'am. Any cinematic dance. So, that is the problem. Cinematic dance is not bad at all. Even my daughter used to find it very difficult to run and dance, you know, for this in the cinema. She said, Anu, I'm so strong in my Bharatanatyam. I'm a student of Adyar Lakshman. So I'm finding it very uncomfortable to do the dance movements in cinema. So that's it. But they asked me, but I tried to really motivate them, give them some good ideas. But one thing I tell you, whatever be the dance form, when we have our Indian classical basic learning, it always really contribute a lot. Just like Carnatic music, just like classical music. The classical music and classical dance, once the child, it gets into it, that will never go from.
Yes,
so I try to, I always try to brainwash them. Come and do something.
Great. Thanks, Vikramji, for being with us.
Thank you.
Lovely, Vikramji, for being with us. We are very proud of you. Thank you very much. Madam, one more question that we are now going to one more wonderful student, Shruti Iyer, who's been a very good inspiration and she's performing a lot and everywhere and promoting Mohiniyattam to a very great extent. Shruti ji, welcome.
Thank you.
You're promoting Mohiniyattam to a very great extent. We are very proud of you. What sort of training you got from your Guruji? How you got into this and how you became so much famous and so many performances to your credit?
Sir, I should really be thankful to God Almighty and also to one more dear student of hers only, Dr. Aruna Thampi. So when I was in my post-grad, I was into Bharatanatyam hardcore and doing it. And then I kind of lost that. I got into life sciences. So I was in JRF and IAC, you know. So avaga I had a little bit of gap with actually dancing and all. So then I asked Aruna ma'am, who was there as a music teacher and also we were doing. And she introduced me one day to Sridevi ma'am. So I'm from proper south side of Bangalore and I traveled all the way to Billindur so far. And I just saw ma'am. I met her, I just saw ma'am. I don't know what struck me. I just said, I am going to learn from her a new art form. I'm a proper Bharatanatyam, like 14 years or so I have done and all those. And then changing over to Mohiniyattam, I just saw ma'am and I felt, okay, I'm going to subject myself to her and she is going to just take. She just walked me through what I am today. I think it's Sridevi ma'am who just thought that I could take up Mohiniyattam as my profession. She has been a major, major role in this and she has inspired us. So whenever she has told that, Mohiniyattam aage yaave aage dance form, there is no linguistic barrier to dance. So that is what she has been promoting. Whether it is a Swati Tirunal Pradam or whether it is a Dasara Pada, ashte involvement, ashte research, ashte dedication to choreography, little details, the mythology. She has been instrumental in inculcating us also to you know, there should be no linguistic barrier at that. And dance also for her is a therapy, she says. So Adina Nage, she has been teaching it to us and all those. And I, being a non-Malayali, you know, taking Mohiniyattam to, you know, like fish to water, it is just because ma'am has been instrumental behind this. And she's never, you know, if it is a Dasara Pada, Agli, Yavde Agli, the language for me was a very big, thing to understand. Yeah. When I was doing my Arangetram, I think ma'am was very patient enough to just tell me the, you know, nuances. It's a heritage that she has passed on to me. You know, when you're learning a new art form from a new state or something, so it's a heritage, the culture, why is it done so, yaake hige, the mythology, all these things painstakingly with so much patience she has been able to give it to us. So thank you so much, ma'am. We have been, so much of research, so much of knowledge that has been passed down. It is such a blessing to
I'm
be
so
with
happy.
Her, such an instruction.
Yeah, a guru also,
and also
good students, dedicated students. I'm lucky in that way. I had a big bunch of flowers with me.
Good.
Ma'am has never taught us as students. She's always referred to as her, you know, she sees her own daughter in all of us. So, adu untara trust, adu untara namike, the guru sishya parampara antivala, sir. So, that has been something with this generation we don't see, sir. Ivaga classes vartare, hoktare, that is there something. But with ma'am, you spend time with the guru, you sit, you eat, you be with her from morning till evening. Adu guru sishya parampara is something that we have luckily had to have with ma'am. So thanks to Almighty for that.
Yeah, Shruti ji, you have gone so deep into your Guruji and you had a very good relations. What do you think now? Do you have a big responsibility for the society as a youngster now? You should carry the tradition what your Guruji has given to you to others.
Yes.
Have you attempted something to do and teach somebody, or you are just performing and promoting? Yeah.
No, ma'am has also groomed us to be in, into, if you are giving how to conduct programs, if arangetram agli, yavde show agli, lecture demonstration agli. So it's not an only like you learn, come dance, you learn the routine and you pass it on or you perform somewhere. But it also is like, how do you present it? What goes on behind the stage? How do you do this? How do you approach people? How do you give it to them? And also when you're teaching, she was right when she has been told that, you know, when you teach, it gives you more, you start learning more about yourself and learning the concepts better. So after that, she had given me an opportunity to teach Bharatanatyam or also learn alongside in her institute. Hagene nanu ivaga, whenever I work in National Center for Biological Sciences. Alli kuda, I go to the creche there, I teach the kids, I have online classes, I've been teaching quite some time for this. Mohiniyattam with ma'am's blessing, I do, teach or perform and all those. So I am continuing my learning with ma'am, albeit a little, erratic episode, but yeah, it's a responsibility that she has passed on to us. So we also tell that, either it's Mohiniyattam, yavde language agli, shouldn't be a barrier to dance. Dance is one language, as she always says, and it's always for the divine. When she says she even dances now, it's because for Krishna. So it's always the divinity is something that is being driven for us. That is me.
Yeah.
We are all not driven by money like our teacher.
Thank you, Shruti ji, for being
you,
wonderful
thank you,
with us and learning so much from your great guru. And you are trying to pass it to all other generations who are going to come. Wonderful to have you with us. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Guruji, we have one more question now. You passed it this wonderful art to so many of your students who are wonderful dancers who are staying all around the world, around the country, even in Karnataka, they're doing wonderful performances. How did you teach this art to your own daughter? Did she learn it eventually, or it came to her?
Yeah, it's a valid question, Sai. Because My daughter also has learned Mohiniyattam from me. We were performing. We had done together for 1.5 hours full kacheri in Chowdhaya for Nelta Srinivas's Noobra festival. But she was not for Mohiniyattam. She wanted to be a brisk dancer in Bharatanatyam and Kathak. So in the Bharatanatyam, Padmini Ramachandran taught her, but that was my dream. My dream, oh. I fulfilled to my daughter. And she had her a full-fledged arangetram when she was 9 years under Padmini Ramachandran. Then later on, to Guru Adyar Lakshman. And that was very serious dance. And I was totally focusing on her Bharatanatyam. And even once I tried something very funny and something very special, something very personal, I tell you, Sai, and to my friends here, Monisha, my daughter, she didn't like me doing Bharatanatyam. She put some complex in me. I was doing, actually, I started learning from Padmini and even Nattuvangam and the basic called this Bharatanatyam from Adyar Lakshman sir. And she said, Thala medithu, tattu, tattu. Then I started doing the Nattuvangam. And she was in the class. And after that, and said, Ni aadu. Then I thought they in the tatayunda, whatever they were doing, I was just doing at the back and doing it. Nalla pandrene, nalla aramandi irukudhu. Then after that, then she was not very happy. She said, no, whenever you do Bharatanatyam, it looks just like Mohiniyattam. Bharatanatyam is another school of Then I got a complex. Then I started focusing on her, and she was an excellent Bharatanatyam dancer. Everybody knew about it. And she did almost within the short span of time, I tell you, till 21, from nine years to 21 years, she had done full-fledged sponsored 35 solo kacheris all around the place, all around the stages. And that was the big thing. So I saw, I could get my dream, you know, materialized in her. So I was very happy. So that is the way I continued with my Mohiniyattam. But now, after Mohiniyattam, I thought now I can't move much of my body because of the natural process of your physical problems. Natural. So Bhavandritta. This Bhavandritta from the heart will never get aged at all.
Yeah.
This is what I believe. Yes. Yeah. So yeah. You enjoy, you make others also enjoy. Carry them to your heart. You go to their heart.
Yeah, that's right. That's what your right. daughter was, I think your daughter was very right that you look like a wholesome Mohiniyattam artist. One beautiful, with that beautiful glamour, the tejas in your eyes, in your face, and when you just come, we all feel that great artist Mohiniyattam
nice,
has
nice
come
to. Hear that.
Yeah, 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 yeah. And we have so many festivals coming up. Yeah,
yes.
We have so many festivals happening in our country here and there.
Yes.
And with us, we have one more festival organizer. His name is Gopal Sagar, who does a lot of festivals in Shumaga and Sagar. And he is with us, and we would like to have him with us. He does festivals in very open air theater like. And minimum art, people, he puts around chairs of. Nearly 2,500 chairs. It is filled and people are standing and seeing his shows. It happens for a 2 days or 3 days festival in Sagar.
Okay.
It's a wonderful place in Karnataka.
Yes.
And Sagarji, namaskar, welcome. Gopalji. He's a wonderful dancer himself, dance guru, teaching a lot of students. Gopalji, we have a great guru, Sridevi Uniji, who is, I think our students have already performed in your festival quite some time back. They have performed Mohiniyattam.
My girls have come.
Yes. Your girls have performed all over the world. And Gopalji, how do you, your mic is mute, Gopalji. How do you feel?
Namaste.
Yeah.
Namaste Gopalji.
Gopalji, how do you feel having
2017 your students are performed in my festival?
2017.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yes.
Madam, it's not a question. I ask one thing. What is your opinion regarding dance festivals in Karnataka or in Kerala or in some other places of India or in abroad?
Your voice is cracking. What is the question?
Your opinion regarding Bharatanatyam dance festivals in Karnataka or in Kerala or some other places of India or in abroad? What is your opinion?
You mean regarding the festivals generally?
Yeah, totally. Yeah.
I tell you, festival when time immemorial, those days itself, Devadas were dancing, Apsaras were dancing, festivals were there in Indra Sabha. So we have to have the festivals because festivals bring all of us together. So many artists interact and exchange their ideas, and we learn. We learn a lot of things, no? You learn from me, I learn from you. Like that. Every child, every artist, that is a, I tell you, to be an artist, you should have a blessing. Only the blessed souls are artists, according to me. So you have to have the festivals. I had conducted a lot of festivals because only through the festivals you can reach to people.
Sure.
No?
Really?
Yeah. So if you have 100 artists on the stage, you are giving a big opportunity for an artist to showcase their talent. No, they enjoy. Either, not only that, I always tell my students also, whether they're small girls and they do, one festival, when you conduct a festival to your other people, the whole family is involved in that.
Sure.
The whole family, yeah. At home, oh, my girl, my boy is dancing for him, for that I had to buy, this I had to put, the dressing. It's a big excitement. It's a big excitement in the family. It's valued a lot. So that much of time, they have so much of happiness in the family life or the friendship. Everything happens there. Festivals can bring lots of good things for the society. No doubt of it. Because I had gone to Hampi Festival, Kadamba Festival, with Mohiniyattam, with all the support of other festival organizers. So I also organized a lot of festivals for others. I was enjoying that. Festival you have to have, not only here, all around the world, you should have festivals. That's the main Utsava. Because life itself is a festival. Love itself is a Utsava. Otherwise, we'll go drag.
Great.
Really?
Thanks, Gopalji, for that, being with us.
Big festival or small festival. Festival is a festival, right? Habba. We have.
Thanks, Gopalji, for being with us. Yeah. Next, you should invite madam to your festival. That is true.
Yeah.
Wonderful. Sure. Thank you, Gopalji, for being with
us. Thank you.
Madam, do you think these festivals has to go on and on, what you said? And do you think the state government, central government are doing justice to the taxpayers and all the artists who are being involved? Are they promoting the young artists? Are they promoting the senior artists like Sangeet Natak Academy, Ministry of Culture, and so many zones are there?
That's a very deep question, actually. And we call it, we should get it. There is a proverb in Malayalam. You should give the bhiksha in the deserving bowl. That is happening here. No, you have to give the bhiksha in the deserving bowl. We have to differentiate. No, the officials or anybody, they have to differentiate who really needs, who is a pure artist, who really needs. And we need according to the production size also. Suppose you want to do tomorrow Mahabharata, you can have with a small amount of money. You want to do it in a proper way, you need a big money. Okay, you don't have the big money, go for a smaller festival. There also. And I don't like people taking money from the artist and conducting festivals also, because we have come to that level, because organizers have no money. No, we have to pay the we have to pay the rent, we have to pay for that, everything. We have to, at least we don't have to pay each other, but the expense should be met, right? That's what it's like a funding. So what we can do, we have to come to that level. But I think our officials or the office, whatever the departments, can really help the artist in the priority base or according to that, without any other fussy in between. Because I had got a lot of grant when I was doing Mohiniyattam Festival, minimum grant I was getting from Karnataka, the government of Karnataka, very nicely, the Kannada and culture. And I used to go and beg with the bangers. That's the way I was conducting. So most of the things, though the artists are always with a little begging ball, the real artists. If you have got a lot of money, if you got a regular income, if you are only an artist, if the only the income is from the art, it is very difficult to survive. That is the one big That's point it. In our day-to-day life.
Day-to-day
it's life. A very right. That is why all the artists were lesser artists in our society those days. They were like an entertainers because they had no okay. money. So we have to work and even the tax or whatever it is for the artists, yeah. there should be some real consideration.
Consideration. Real consideration.
Now see what happened. Yeah, like, we can't have one stage. Where is the, we are all in the small boil meeting.
Yes.
How sad. Yeah. You know, so there was, it is nobody's mistake. But we have to overcome like it.
Have, Like we have Sangeet Natak Academy in New Delhi, which is for the artists promotion, and it has got more than 50 crores per year budget, more than 50 crores. So do you think such organization of central government is promoting the most promising, like you said, the professional young artists to take it up seriously? Are Sangeet Natak Academy awards and all this, are they going really in the style which it has to go?
I think that it's not going in the serious way. People have taken it very light. That's what I feel. Okay. For me, it is so difficult to apply for a grant and to get, I don't know, I have no mouthpiece. I have to go there. I have no one to recommend. I myself have to struggle to get little money. And even till I the central government one grant still owed, after 20 years also I haven't got the full money. Those days only one landline, you know, landline phone call. How many calls I can make? I can't speak Hindi. Language is a problem. And they said, you know, file is there, either, either and all. I was, then finally what happened? I said, okay, no. But if any... if that nothing like that, if our academic people can do, they can do wonders, no? Wonders. No, every artist will be very happy. Now, can survive. No, but this is for the new generation. Our generation is okay. This is for the younger generation. And they have to be encouraged. They have to be, you know, divided it, no? Divide, some nice division, financial division should be there. No, I don't know how to. I don't know how it happens. Going to happen, but I dream that for the next generation.
Yeah. In your journey, you had a very long journey. You had a very long journey, wonderful journey, right from your younger days, and you traveled, you gave programs all over the country, abroad, everywhere. Was there any godfather for you to promote? Do you have somebody to promote? Who pushed you to all this level?
No, to become only such a my famous godfather artist? Was only my husband. I can call you. I didn't have any godfathers in any field because I myself think that I'm a godmother. That is the confidence I have. And my husband used to support me a lot. He said, go do that. Yeah, okay, girl. And here, Anthony, I have to mention Dwaraki Krishnaswamy. She is a mother here for me. She mentored me into the Karnataka, all the Dasara. I had a Dasara festival. That was in just before the pandemic. She gave me some 13 kritis. I did that in A.D. Rangamandira. And Narada Koravanji, that is her production. She won Vadi Rajas. Narada Koravanji, she gave me. She said, that is the way I did complete Kannada, old Kannada. You know it, sir. You had met me that time. And we are so young. I still have got your special photography. Sai is a very big, highly talented photographer also. I don't know whether you are doing it. Fantastic. I got all the photos and the videos you have taken. You are very young that time. Fantastic it was. Yes, it is with me. I see the dress I have. I put one Kuranji. You have given me some flash. It's still with me. So many. See, the talents are there. Man, you're a good dancer and your family.
Thank you.
All of them are still Very nice.
What do you think about this? What do you think about the awards? State awards, national awards, and Padma awards, Sangeet Natak Akademi awards, all this. Do you think right persons are getting, according to you, who are professionally striving it, or it is influential, or recommended by somebody, or by luck? What do you feel?
What I feel for my Karnataka Kalashi Award and Pravasi Kerala Kalashi Award and all, I just came to me. I didn't know there is an award also, because I never, ever, my personal thing, I'll tell you later. So one day when I was in, after I lost my daughter and I was missing her a lot, I was just doing something in the house with her cupboard, and I got a call from Mysore Subramaniam sir. He called her, Sridevi, how many years you have been staying in Bangalore? I said, that time it was 30 years. Only just, yes, sir. Good. I will come back to you. Like that. You deserve something from Karnataka. So that was a big abhiman for me. I was so proud of it. And I was crying, actually. And I called over my husband over the phone. I said, I was crying. I said, what happened? I said, this is what's happening in Karnataka. Mata is giving me this. Like that, no? So there, I didn't know that. I didn't have any recommendation. Nobody has given me, even the other one also. Even Chandana Award, I was shocked. Like that. But there are a lot of deserving people. They are not in the limelight. People don't know them. So nowadays, you need a self-promotion. Suppose an artist is good, he or she should come forward, because now the artists are in abundance. There are a lot of talents. It is completely very competitive now. It's not small like before. It's not like 25 years back or 30 years back. There's so much of talents around. So much of opportunities around. How much they are spending. So many are there. So it will be very nice that deserving people can get this kind of award. Award means, award is okay. Any award is welcome, right? It's a recognition. From the government level, if you are getting some, that means you have really proved some, you are somebody in this field. But there are a lot of, I used to think about some people, why they haven't got yet so much, got any recognition. I used to think, some people, no, and I see that, oh my God, what a talent, and much, much higher talent. I used to feel that. But there is a process, right? Everything has got a process. You have to go through the process also, then try. I don't know whether it is very doing. Sometimes they are doing it. That's it. But any award is fine. Any award is fine. We have to try also. You should try, you know.
Good.
I think now Modi also, the Prime Minister
right.
had
that's right.
some Padma Award and all. Yeah. See, then I thought,
Modi ji has introduced a wonderful concept. Yeah.
That means many people will think that I'm getting
yourself. That's right.
That's a big thing that they have to work towards that, right? That's an inspiration. It's a motivation for them.
That's right.
Youngsters or elders also. At least the elders, relatives, or you know, the people like me, I'm a very senior citizen now. Though I am very happy with you all, more energetic when I see the younger crowd. But there is a limitation for me. So the people older people, the youngsters should go forward and find out what are their qualifications, then present them for an award. That is also possible.
Good.
But award is it's a recognition anyway. Yeah. Even in a small thing, give it to a child for your perspective. It's something nice for them, right? To keep.
Great. You are nice. So much of affection for the youngsters. So we all appreciate. We have with us one more youngster called Somshekhar Chudanath. Somshekhar Chudanath is a very talented youngster who's been dancing for a long time, and he has taken this as a profession. He has also done his master's degree in Bharatanatyam, and he has toured around the world with many dancers and choreographed and presentation. Somu, we are with great guru Sridevi Uniji, who is a Mohiniyattam specialist and professionalist. Somu, would you like to share something, your views with madam?
Yes, definitely, sir. Namaste, ma'am. It's so great honor to talk with you. my one question is, learning classical art form, you've been practicing from so many years. So what is learning of this classical form made an impact in your life? So through that, what is the message that you want to convey to the younger generation? Like how it is important to learn the classical art form, whether they take it as a profession or they just learn it. But what is that impact and what is the advantage of learning our Indian art form? So if you are experiencing...
No, a lot of advantages is their learning because it's a total discipline. You know, it is not a yoga. This is a yoga. There is no doubt of it. You have a lot of advantage as an individual. As an individual, you have, you get the discipline, everything you want. But there is a question mark. What is your livelihood? That is the one big question mark. Only dance, you may not be able to. Unless you are form a school and you start training others, then you can slowly build up your life. And whatever be the way. And or teaching in big universities and things like that also after research. All those things. But it's all your choice. But if you have all the dance forms, everything in one side and you can hold a very... very strong profession one side. So that will be the source, regular income. But you don't have to learn, then leave it. Never leave dance. Once you are just like driving, you learn dancing for your own discipline, for your own creativity, and you become a better human being. That is very good. Meanwhile, your financial position, you have to always balance. You can't be carried away by that. Because of the present scenario. Because the present said, no, this is the way. A lot of things are there. Otherwise, I strongly wish our government can really make a very, very big support for those who wants to continue only as dance, as a dance teacher or a dancer or a performer. But no regrets in learning dance. It is good for a boy or a girl because it's something, it's not something above, something above. But meanwhile, you have to find another way also. It is like parallel. Like I have to say that because we have no landlords or we have no kings or now the promoters as a dancer in their court or in their festival, nothing. We have no choice. We have no chance. So both should go together. So that's what I had.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you so much. It was nice talking.
Is it okay for you? I don't know.
Yes, ma'am.
This is what I felt.
Definitely, ma'am. It's
my nice very personal feeling.
Great.
I'm very anxious. Really anxious about the young dancers. Once I told, not mentioning the name, I just told, I congratulate, hats off to you, this couple. How do you take dance as your livelihood and you are doing so well? So that is there. That is your own efficiency. You plan, you think and do. You can, the sky is the limit then for the artist. Artists are always have problems, I know. We have problems. Not any other problem, social problem, I'm telling, for the financially. For the regular income, if you are just an artist, even if you are a rock star also, you have the problem. So imagine about the classical level. We are very conservative and we want to really preserve and save our art form. No, we don't say Bharatanatyam or Mohinatyam, Kathakali, anything. That is our tradition. How can we make it? And I'm so happy the youngsters like you are doing so much. So I think the whatever be the way, people have to do something for the young generation of dancers. That's what I dream. I asked when I went as a jury for one of the program in Kerala. We had an open session talk. I said, I wish the whole world is with a lot of dancers and singers with proper financial background. It's proper ingam. So proper ingam. See, we don't have a proper, nice, good food, right? Or a yoga, whatever. You need so many things. You need this runs are fast. So you need. See, and dancers always know, they are always, when they have the discipline, they always look better. They groom themselves. Yes. All handsome. See, he's a handsome boy. No, like, that. So many people are there. I have seen a lot of... Oh, but I hats off to men dancers, male dancers. I really appreciate them for taking this as a challenge in life. It is such. It's not a small thing. It's not a small thing. But never regret that. For a dancer, you'll be proud of it because it's a part of Nadaraja.
I always be wonderful. I always proud of it.
Yeah. One thing, when art is always respected anywhere. Abhiman, that is everywhere. Because that is my thing. Oh, you're a dancer. When you go to an airport, and when I went there and I was in the queue in the Chicago, I was coming there. Oh, you're from India. I said, yes. Are you a dancer? That's foreigner. Yes. I'm an Indian classical dancer. Wow, very good. And she said, pass me off faster. Go. See, that's what it was. I have really enjoyed as a dancer. Yeah. I it's not a glamorous this thing, what a film. But dancer, I said, I'm an actor. Okay, there are so many actors for them. But if I'm in India, if you want to know the value, you have to go out. I went and did two programs 2 years back in London, Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan. What appreciation we get. You know? And there also, you don't expect any money because you have to spend like that. But see, the respect. The respect. But when you run a good institution and all the parents are okay, and you have to teach children, you have to teach the young people, then not only this, you will have a lot of status through that. Automatically, your Dhanalakshmi also will bless you. Mahalakshmi also will bless you. They never give up. You can. I always tell, my grandson is a DJ. He's an English completely the Western music. Yeah, he's doing very well. But because of pandemic and all, little problem. I said, sky is the limit. You hit it. This is what I tell them. Don't worry. Because he has done the background music or the background score for my short film.
Oh.
So that is a big privilege in my life, right? My grandson is doing the background score music for my short film. Yes. So this is the way. I not only promote my children, I promote all, everybody. Because my students know. I send them, you go and do that. Don't bother about me. You go and do that. Be independent. You start your own school. I always tell them. I told Anita, you do Lasyadruda. We named it. She started this thing. I had told another girl, so go do yourself. No, the teachers also should give them the freedom to start their own institution and their own responsibility. They are your result.
Yeah. Thank you, Somshekhar, for being with us. I know it's wonderful. Yeah. The youngsters have got a message now. It should be proud. All the youngsters should be proud that the great guru like Sridevi Muni is saying that you should be dancing. The whole world should be dancing. What a great message, madam. Wonderful. We come for the last question. The last discussion. So much technology has been advanced now. Like you had the real gurus conducting the programs. You had the real musicians, the technical aspects and so on. So, but as the technology has improved, we have come into the media of recorded music. We have come into the technology of electronic systems. And especially now in pandemic, we have come into our mobile. How do you feel this vast change in a professional artist?
Actually, there are plus and minus. Plus is for the teachers or the dancers like me more. Sitting at home and watching everybody. That is the plus. Then another plus point for the youngsters. First, see how many VVIPs have come to your small screen. You go there, you never used to get even an appointment to get them. they will come in your screen. Any VVIPs. So that is the biggest, because we have really understood we are only small. We are not too big. So that. But when this pandemic started, I was really panicking because I have absolutely no knowledge about the technology. I was thinking how to continue my dance. I didn't want to give up. And immediately, I Sarva Characharam, for one dance festival, I started. We had some 20 dancers, my own students, 20 dancers, because they are all IT people, most of them. They have no time, they are tired, and no maid servants, and so husband at home, children are at home, worker at home, and domestic problems, this, that, and all. They had no, not even 5 minutes for them to spare. I said, come on, this is the stress you are going through. Take a break for yourself for 5 minutes. Don't wear all the your costume and jewelry and all. Just put a decent dress. So just do one item for this many minutes. They all did. All the Sarva Characharam. And I got many of the dancers like Vinaya Prasad, Lakshmi Gopal Swami. And so many people came as a chief guest. They blessed the students overnight. Vijayanti Kashi, all of them had come. So that was a big festival, Sarva Characharam. I was so happy, but by the end of the day, I was completely exhausted. Because directly, I didn't have any problem. Direct, you know, all our students will come to our class. We have a very nice time. We will have a lunch together, dinner together, or coffee together, and work and dance and choreography, everything. We had a lot of time to sit and organize. But this time, I know what is Zoom. I don't know what is this thing. But my girls, all of them have supported me very well. I said, come on. I will give only the direction, you know. I know, but I know what I want. What the product I want from them, I know. Till I get. I encourage them. No, ma'am, it is not nice. I'm looking tired. No. It doesn't matter. Tomorrow you do once again. Maybe with a better lighting, because we don't know. How do the lighting and all, because you are a lighting person, you know all this. But people like us, what do you know? We depended on you. Like that. And I somehow managed a very beautiful this thing in Sarva Characharam for Manisha Arts. Then, what is my next step? Days pass by, but I can't take classes because none of them are available. They are all online. So I got very few students. I still continued the momentum of my teaching and my dancing for them. So I dance myself, do the video and send it to them. You learn that and come back to me in the live. Like that, I'm still continuing. Then I thought, what to do? No performance. Then I did Bhavanritta. Bhavanritta, I selected. You know, the musicians, we cannot get them. All the record had already been in the line. You know, the earlier days, yeah, we had full-pitched orchestra. And the orchestra members also became busy. They were also going abroad. So many things, everything. It's the due course, you know, the due course. So many things have happened like that. So we have improved. We have developed our skill to do without that. How do we do? Then the recording. I have recorded full mark, one full margam for Mohiniyattam and 2-3 dance dramas. I like that. Then we presented. But one problem, when you say festivals, they will say, how much you are going to pay the artist? It's a recorded music, no? So there is a problem. Recording is quite a lot of investment is there.
Investment, yes.
They don't want to pay for the artist. No orchestra, no live orchestra, so they don't have to pay to anybody. Just put one draw, CD and do. Dancers we will do. We are very humble with the record, without record or the orchestra and all, we do. We occupy the stage and we do for the Nartanam, for the Saraswati Devi, no doubt of it. For ourselves, we do. We do for the audience, no problem. So that is the problem we started using. And some big festivals, they said you should not use recorded music, only live. So with much money. So only this minimum mridangam, vocal and support. That's all. So what about the other artists who are already being trained for the orchestra? They don't have income. They also have the problem. Isn't it? So it's all it's interconnected.
Yes.
And but this technology, but one thing now, people also started liking this way. When you are, they are recording from the studio and it is available in the internet. Then we are taking from the internet the music and we are dancing.
That's right. So the technology has helped everyone now to advance themselves to travel also, I think so, because when you're traveling abroad, sometimes you don't get so much of budget.
No.
So you go alone. So you just take a CD or something and go alone and perform and come, and it's a professionally recorded. It's wonderful. Great concept. You are also changed to this great system after working for so many decades with great musicians and unique journey of yours. We are very proud of you.
I did some theater work also. I would like to share that. There is a theater. I did Padad Bhim one theater for almost an hour solo theater. I staged it also. My premiere show was over. Then the COVID came after that and all the pandemic.
Okay.
I staged it.
Okay.
That is a very beautiful theme of an elderly lady. So it's a very beautiful one. So that I'm into theater. I like anything.
Yeah, you're into films, you are into pure classical performance in the theater.
You are a whole artist.
You are much
music, Michael Jackson music, everything. For me, music is universal, rhythm is universal. You just keep on.
You are a complete artist. Thank you so much for being with us and blessing us, being in our. Contact and working for this wonderful thing your precious time. You spent your precious time for us, for the Federation of Karnataka Classical Dancers, and for all the dancers in the world. It is a message. your journey is a message. Thank you so much for being with us. We look forward to your blessings.
I want all the dancers to keep dancing. You dance and dance throughout your life.
Yeah.
If you can't dance physically, dance mentally. With your heart and imagine you are a dancer, and you will glow. Wonderful. That's all I had to say.
It's a great message to all that keep dancing. It's the blessings of not at all. You are always welcome. Thank you so much. Your blessings will carry a lot to all the younger generations. We're very happy. Loka samasta sukino bhavantu. Thank you very much.